Hello everyone again, great to see you. We are here learning Figma as a product person. We are learning how to create a lightweight prototype using Figma well enough that we can use it to communicate our ideas with our stakeholders. We're about halfway into the series. Lauren, can you believe we are halfway in?
Yes, this is fun. I'm really enjoying teaching you all this stuff. It's really exciting for me.
I'm enjoying it too, and I'm so happy you're here. We have already covered a lot. We learned about organizing our files, creating our files, libraries, components, styles and variables, shapes and images. Phew, it's been a lot. It's been a wild ride. And we are at our check-in point where I have done some homework for you, Lauren. So a little nervous, but excited to share that with you. And also there are some questions that came up as part of that. So if it's okay awesome. With you, I'd love to first show you what I created and then we can dig into some of those questions I have. Does that sound good?
Yeah, absolutely. Let's do it.
Okay, drum roll.
That's gonna be great.
Okay, Lauren, of everything you've taught me, here is where we've gotten to. I'm gonna start out from the file browser. I took the tips that you had of organizing my sidebar. This is already feeling like I know where to go to get what I need, and I have that homework file that I created right here. So going into that, I've organized it into a project. It's not just living in my drafts, which I feel really proud about.
Excellent. Yeah. You love to hear it.
Yep. And this is what we have so far. So just talking through along the lines sequencing of what we've covered so far. First, I set up my pages. So I have my work in progress here and then a little playground page for me. Then in that, I have sections for the two groups of things that I'm creating. And then in those, I have our frames. And Lauren, I want you to check me. Like, am I using the right terminology here?
Yeah,
am I sounding like I know what I'm talking about?
Yep.
Okay, great. And then I have my frames. I chose to use the iPhone 14 and 15 Pro Max. I love those kind of presets were fun to play around with, but we're creating this mobile flow. So I thought that made the most sense. And then within that, I pulled some of these components that were in our library for some signup elements, some form elements, and this drop down here. So awesome. The whole idea is I'm trying to pitch my team on creating this segmented onboarding experience based on role. And so I was trying to recreate that by having this role drop down. And then what I want to do is for each of the roles that someone selects, we have a custom featured product that we show them. So then I have my welcome screens here. So that's what I have so far. How are we feeling?
Amazing. Great. I think this is awesome. I'm loving that you were able to find the libraries. You're able to use them. One super quick tip that I'm not sure if I showed you how to do this, but one thing that I'm seeing is it's a little hard to see the difference between the background and the section. So you can actually change the section colors right here. If you select them, I'll let you do it since you're screen sharing.
Okay.
Select them. And then the same way that you would change a frame color in the fill right there, if you click add the fill and then change the color of that so that it's a little bit easier to differentiate of the frames versus the sections. So you can change that color there.
Love this. And I was going to pick a random color, but now that I know about my libraries, I'm going to go into one of our brand colors. Hey.
Hey, there you go. Love it.
Oh, that looks beautiful. Loving that. Okay. Amazing. That's an awesome pro tip. Yes, that makes it already just a little bit more visually distinguishes what we have on our canvas here.
Exactly.
Lauren, is it called a canvas? What do you call this general space?
Yeah. You're in the canvas. And one thing about Figma is that it's an infinite canvas. So it literally goes on for days and ever. There's no end to it. And that's why sections can be really helpful because it kind of like gives you a little bit of a home in this infinite canvas. I always find it makes me feel a little bit more comfortable and giving me a place to see what I'm working on right now.
Yes, love that. And I love coloring them. That's huge. Okay, so this brings us to some of our questions that I ran into here. So the first thing, question I had is, as I was structuring my file, I had these frames set up, and then I started adding elements like the shape that I thought was in the frame, but it wasn't in the frame. And how do I know when something's in the frame or not in the frame? And how do I get it in the frame if I want it there?
Yeah, totally. So you're going to take a look at your left-hand side, the layers panel, and that's going to help you understand if it is or isn't in the frame. Yeah. If you click on that rectangle a couple of different ways, if you start dragging the actual rectangle itself now, start dragging that up into the frame, you see it just moved on the layers panel.
Oh, yeah.
And now it's kind of moving around. That's telling you where it's going. If it's indented more, it's inside of the frame there. You can see it has that indent now versus it was on the same level as the frame before.
Yeah.
So that's going to tell you where it is. And you can also manually move those around. So say take that outside of the frame and then manually move it. You can manually move it into something like that.
In our layers panel right here. So I'm moving it. Okay. Wow. Okay. That's super helpful.
There's also something clip content. If you are select your frame right there.
Okay.
Yep, perfect. And if you go to your right-hand side now and see, go down a tiny bit right there, there's clip content. Uncheck that. You can
Whoa.
see this is really great if you're dealing with something that's overlapping, like peeking itself outside, like this rectangle is right now.
Oopsies.
It's still inside of the frame, but you can see the whole thing. Versus if you have clip
Ah.
content on, you're only going to be able to see what is there for that frame size. So this also might help a little bit. If you can still see it and it's outside of the frame and the clip content is on, that
Yeah.
means that it's not actually in the frame.
Ah, that makes sense. Cool. Okay. So I got my things in my frames. That feels great. It's nice to have that double check of being able to look in the layers panel and know that everything's there. What was happening is I was turning it off and I thought it would turn off. Let's see, like this one. Not in my
Yep.
frame.
Okay, so let's check that
See?
one. Yep,
So it
totally.
sounds like I need to drag it into the frame. Ah,
Yep, there you go.
Lauren. Okay, great.
There we go.
That's huge. Yeah, because I was hiding things and it just wasn't showing everything that was there. And I was like, what is going on?
Totally.
Okay, awesome. And then, okay, I'm going to ask about resizing components. I noticed, I think we talked about this, but I want to just dig into this a little bit more. I have my components here and I want to maybe say resize this button and I would drag, but the text isn't resizing. It's not resizing everything. And if I go
Right.
smaller, it's like, so how do I get it where it resizes at scale?
Exactly. So you said the right word there. Scale is what you're trying to do right here,
Okay.
versus resizing it is going to keep the font size or things like that at
Yeah.
the same size, versus scaling is what you want to do. So to get to scale, you're going to click K on your keyboard.
Okay.
And
Oh.
then you're going to notice the right side changed. So now you can either drag it out or you can specify if you want it 2x, if you want it a certain size
Wow,
that way.
cool.
You can drag it right from the canvas, but that's going to scale everything.
Ooh, that's exactly what I needed. Okay.
Yep.
Scaling. Good to know. So I wasn't doing it wrong with resizing. It's just that's not what
Yep. And
resizing
then to get out of
does.
scale, I think you did great. You got out of scale. Sometimes I often get stuck in scale and then I'm like, what am I doing? To get out of scale, it's V. So into
V.
scale is K, out of scale is V.
Good to know. Good to know. Okay. The next thing that I feel like might be a big one and probably is getting into auto layout, which I know we're talking about next. But so I started adding these components and it has this little swap me thing that I can swap. But I want to add a drop down here, but I couldn't figure out how to do that as part of this component. So I just brought in another component for my drop down menu. And even in here, like I couldn't figure out how to add in another option in this menu. How do I add things to my, how do I add things to my components, I guess is the question.
Okay, so that does get a little bit deep, but a couple of different ways that we can do this right here. So in let's look at the swap me one.
I'll pull
If
this one
you
up.
go you're selected on the swap me and you go to your right-hand side.
Yeah.
And this, we've set up our components specifically like this. Like, obviously, not everybody will have a little swap me component. But if
Yeah.
you select it on that one and where it says, let's see, actually, command click so that you're specifically selected on the swap me part. Because now, there we go. Perfect. So, where on the right-hand side, it says content slot
Yeah.
right there, you're going to drop down there. And that's where you're going to be able to change the component out, basically.
Oh, here, I need to switch my library. All
Yep.
libraries.
All libraries, perfect. There you go. So that was able to swap that out.
That's so cool. Okay, so now I have this. How do I add more menu items here?
So this is where we're going to have to get into detaching components, because unless the person who's created this component has set this up with component properties and variants so that they have like certain amounts of menu items, like one, two, three, four, which
Yeah.
people will definitely set things up that way.
Yeah.
Unless they've set it up that way, we can't just automatically add something into a component. But what we can do here is we can detach, which
Okay.
that gets controversial again, another controversial,
Right.
but I think especially for what we're doing,
Yeah.
it's not like we're sending this to a development team. We're just trying
Right.
to get our ideas across. So what we can do is detach. So you're in the right place. You
Ah.
right click. You're going to do detach component. So now once it's detached, you can double click on one of those and even just copy and paste.
I did Control C, Control V. What?
Yep. And this worked out perfectly because it's auto
Cool.
layouted. So it was able to easily get that in. If it wasn't auto layouted, it wouldn't necessarily do that. And we'll talk about that in our next lesson.
Yeah, I can't wait to dig into auto layout, but that is, it feels like magic to me. Because I don't know how
Yes.
it's set up, but it did what I wanted it to. And all it was a Control C, Control V. I can add so many items.
Yep. All the items.
All the items. Okay, that is awesome. So powerful. Okay, what we did there, just to recap, is I selected the actual object here, and then I went to the content slot and switched out for one of our other instances here. And
Yep, for
then
a different component. Yep.
once we brought in the menu component, I detached that instance and then was able to edit how many items I had in the list.
Exactly. Yep.
So cool. Okay, cool. I will apply that and put all my different roles in there. Feeling good about that. We talked about editing the elements. So I have these. The next question I had was about styles. So I took a cue off of your cute animals and
Yay.
brought in these cute animals. And then I set up these styles. I brought in the images and then I applied a fill over them with a transparent kind of color here. And I was wondering, is it possible to just copy one part of this as a style and apply that to other places? Or is it like an all or nothing for the styles?
You should be able to copy just one. So if we're selected on this one over here, if you hover over just the purple, for example, on the right side panel and go like really to the left a little bit, there's like a tiny bit of space. You'll see three little lines. If you click on there, that should highlight that. So, and then just copy that, Command C, and then let's try it on like
Let
just
me
a
just, yeah, let me just get
one
this
that's
one
not
off.
done.
Okay.
Yeah, get rid of that guy and then try it on there.
Okay, it's on my image now and Command V. What?
So
So you
there
can
you
just
go.
copy. What? That's so cool. Okay.
Very handy so that you don't have to keep remembering or keep applying specific ones. So you can copy and paste styles.
Yes.
You can do that with gradients and all sorts of things there too.
I love that. So that makes it easy then. So then, if I got that correctly, what we're doing is we're selecting just that part of this style, and then I can very easily just go in and select all of my things and paste them all at once.
Awesome.
Yay! That makes it so easy to apply that. Love that. Great. Okay. And then, last question here is about alignment. So let's say these ones that I just had here, are there any best practices for getting things aligned? Because I often feel like I'm dragging them. I want them to be centered, and I'm just not sure, is this in the center? I see all these guides, but is there a best practice for aligning things all at once?
Yeah, so a couple of different things around this. So if we are looking at just these images right here and we select them all, so actually I'll let you select them. Select all those images and then in the top right-hand corner, you'll see a couple of different ways of aligning. So the first one that I would click is the one with the grid all the way to the right. And that's going to tidy up is what I use a lot of just making sure that everybody has an equal distance. It gets a little bit funky like this when you have different size images. So from here, we can do a couple of different things. One that's really handy to know is, I can't believe I didn't tell you this yet, but this might have been the first thing I learned in Figma is if you are selected, so select one of the like the image that I'm on up here, this little puppy. Click on this puppy and then unclick and then hold down the option key and start to move over to different. There you go. So you can see right there, see how it's telling you the exact distance that is. So that's really handy if you want to make sure that everybody is the same exact distance apart or like a very specific distance. Like product designers use 8 pixels a lot. So if you want to make sure that it's 8 pixels, there we go. So that's really handy. But then, yeah, the alignment tools are all going to be really helpful to make sure that you're center aligned. And a lot of times, too, when you're like, if we go back to how you were trying to make sure that this was center aligned. So this is where I would click on it. I would hold down option to see, okay, what's the distance on each side? So it should say
So if I click on
carry
it and
over.
then hold down, click on it, hold down.
There you go. So
Oh,
now
so
you
it's
can see
not
exactly.
centered. See? This is what I was worried
Yep. And then what you could do too is let me duplicate this guy just so we can see it on his own. And let me make this like really not centered, clearly not centered. And this guy's over here. If we wanted everything on here to be centered, I could select everything on here and then click the center alignment. So that just center aligns.
Wait, and so the center line is, so I select these two elements here and then I just click this button here. Is that right? The center line? What? That's so
There you
magical.
go. And you'll see that line that's coming up too. It's Figma's trying to hint at you like, okay, this once you get to that, it'll snap to that center line and telling you where the center is for things. The aligning tools up in the right-hand corner are super helpful.
Wow, love that. Okay. I have learned so much. That option tool is so powerful.
Yes, that one is a very handy one. There's one thing that I remembered. This one, people inevitably fall into it and they're like, what happened? And so I never know when to bring it up, but I want to bring it up.
Please.
Something that might accidentally happen is if you accidentally hit Command Y, see what happens on your screen.
Command.
Boom. So
What?
if you ever get yourself in this situation, this is outline mode. And it can be very handy to see if there's anything hidden on your screen. See, like you can see the things
Wow.
have been cropped off, if the clip content is on. But a lot of times people will do this and they'll get there and they'll be like, what did I just do? So I like to always let people know Command Y to get out of it
I
on a Mac.
love that. That almost looks like a wireframe right here. That's so cool.
Yeah.
Wow, powerful. Okay, Command Y, on and off. Love that. Okay, we learned so much. I got my questions answered about getting things in frames. We figured out how to resize or scale components, I suppose we should say. We figured out how to swap out components in different instances and detach those instances to expand them, and then applying parts of our styles as well as aligning everything. Ah, Lauren, we've learned so much.
You get it. You're doing it. You're
We're
amazing.
doing it. And look, we're getting close.
And look at how much you've created with just a few lessons. You've been able to create basically some wireframes that are very much usable.
For sure. I'm feeling like a magician and I'm not, but
You
that's
are.
only because of your great teaching. Thank you, Lauren.
You bet.
Yeah, so I feel like we have the building blocks here in place. We're starting to get the visual elements that we need. And now it's a matter of leveling this up and making it a little bit more interactive and a little bit more responsive to changes. I think that we'll be covering that next, right, Lauren?
Yes, that will responsiveness is key there. That'll get into auto layout, and then we'll get into some prototyping too to really get that interaction going.
I can't wait. So excited. Okay, we'll be back tomorrow with auto layout and then continue on from there. Thank you so much,
Awesome.
Lauren.
Cool. See you soon.
See y'all soon.